Welcome to another episode of Soul Aligned Success. And today I'm going to share with you how to finally kick imposter syndrome to the curb once and for all. So today I'm going to share with you how to step into your next level self. And maybe you'll have a little resistance to this video. And if it does cause resistance, then maybe that's a little bit of self-reflection that's required on your part. But this is what I see happening a lot. And this is what has happened in my own experience in the past. And I wanted to share it with you. You're often the teacher and the student at the same time. You're probably already aware of that. And you probably are finding that you are teaching the very same thing that you're in the process of learning. This doesn't mean that you haven't come full circle in your transformation enough to where you're able to help others. You are. In fact, you're so aware of the process of the healing journey and of the transformational journey that you are intimately aware with all of the different facets of it so that you can clearly help guide others. But here's the thing, you're not attached to your client's limited stories. You're not attached to their money story. You're not attached to their memories. You're not attached to all the limited belief systems and structures they have going on in the limited programming. You're not attached to all of that stuff. This is why it's so easy for you to get the transformation for your clients, yet you often struggle with the same thing or that you're working through the same thing. And this is because, partly by design, because as a lightworker, teacher, and a healer, you go through the process. It's no accident that you get to go through the process with crystal clear awareness so that you can shine the light for others. You don't really get a shortcut through the transformational journey, even though you're here now to help accelerate that process for others. You go through what you go through so that you can gain the clarity and the wisdom, right? And then when the student is ready, the teacher appears and you start teaching and helping others heal their life. And since you're not attached to all of their bullshit limited belief structures and programming, it's easy for you to get their results for them. But you still have a lot of your own baggage that makes it harder for you to get the results for yourself. So often I see the women that pop up on the strategy calls with me to grow their business, recognizing that they are their ideal client, that they are their dream soulmate client. If they could just take a dose of their own advice, take a dose of their own medicine, they would catapult themselves forward. And this is true, because what happens is you come all the way through your journey, all the way through. But at the very end, before you can finally take both feet out of your old self and into your new self, you have to cross through this sort of like fire, you know, this fire, fear of fire, you know, I don't know, I call it fire, like stepping through the fire, right? Like stepping through the fear, stepping through the fire. You have to take that final leap. You have to take that final jump from your old self to your new self, to your next level self. And it requires all of the fears, all of the limited beliefs, all of the imposter syndrome, all of that stuff out the window. Like all of it has to go. It requires all the courage, all the confidence for you to move forward and walk your talk and share your truth, speak your message, yes, but walk your talk in your own life, not just when you're helping other people. And yes, you're doing this in your own life, facets of it, but there's usually a key element that you're not doing, that's that last piece of the puzzle that's holding you back, that's keeping you from catapulting yourself forward. And then once you do catapult yourself forward and you step into your next level self, now you've energetically up-leveled, and this is where like the floodgates open for you to truly help pull others up through the same process. It's like a rite of passage almost. It's like a rite of passage where you literally have to take this final step, Like, you've been doing the work, you're aware, you're conscious of it, you see the process in and out, and the fact that you've been so aware through the process and through the transformation is completely serving you and part of your mission, because as a lightworker, teacher, healer, you're here to share this with others and know it on such an intimate level that you're able to help facilitate the process in others. But there's this last piece. There's this last lingering piece that keeps you in doubt, that keeps you in fear, that keeps you in procrastination, that keeps you in imposter syndrome, that keeps you in all these things. And that's the piece that when you finally take action on it, you know, and take a dose of your own medicine and walk your talk and up level yourself, despite all of the limited beliefs and programming stuff like that you've been clearing or that may still linger, it's like this last hurdle. Okay, it's like you're running the race and you're like the last leg of the relay, and you've been helping all along the way, helping others, oftentimes over giving to others even before you give to yourself, right? There's a reason for that. It's because there's a lack of worthiness there that keeps you with unhealthy boundaries. But yet you're really able to help other people heal, but yet you still have the unhealthy boundaries. Why is that? It's because you still have to step fully into your power and leave the past behind. And as you do that, and you take a dose of your own medicine, and you walk your talk, the last shred of imposter syndrome fades away and you get to move forward with unwavering and unapologetic confidence and courage in your mission. So if this resonates with you, I'd love to hear from you. Please leave me a comment below this video wherever you're watching it, or you can shoot me a DM over on Instagram at @spiritualceo. And as usual, there's the Soul Aligned Success Masterclass. It's also accessible below this video wherever you're watching it. And if you're feeling called, I would love to see you on the masterclass. Namaste.